All right, we ready for our first guest?
We are. So let's just get right to it. So our first guest that we're going to introduce is Jennifer Hernandez. Jen, welcome.
Thank you. Hi.
Jen is a senior loan officer for Legacy Mutual Mortgage, which is based in Houston, Texas. She has over 25 years of experience, 4,000 loans closed, and won Houston's Mortgage Lender of the Year in 2018 and 2019. That's awesome. So welcome you.
Thank you.
Welcome, Jennifer. All right, this is super, it's fast paced and time goes quick. Got 10 minutes here. We've got the opportunity to work together in several occasions through referrals and also events, and it's been fun. And you've done some really unique things, and I've seen you evolve even in the short time that we've gotten to work with each other. So here's the question we're asking today. How can real estate professionals like you avoid becoming a lowest price commodity? And for this is for the audience. We talked about this before, but more for the audience to clarify what this question is. Competition, it's out there, it's growing. That's just business. You got big tech, you got smart local operators. Everyone's feeling a squeeze. But how can you avoid that? How can you avoid being squeezed out to like the lowest price, flat fee guy?
So I think, I've always been 100% referral. I've never been the lowest in the market for 25 years, but I do feel now with technology as years have passed and in the most recent past, I mean, even I'm squeezed on rate, right? So number one is generate more leads than you can handle, so that you can cherry pick the ones that want to do business your way. So that's like a Raving Fans. If you haven't read the Raving Fans book, that's the basic principle. Identify what you want, identify what your client wants, make sure there's a fit, and then deliver wow plus one. So that's number one. So really define who your client is and who your client isn't. I remember back to when I was first in the business, I would like anything with dirt under it. I was like, I will finance it. I don't regret what I did because it really made me hustle and work hard. And not that I don't work hard now. I'm not trying to say that. I'm just saying that with wisdom and years, I've learned, I wish I had established earlier, this is the kind of business that I'm willing to take and this isn't. So when I've sacrificed, you know, my either time or things that kind of go against my ideal client, it doesn't always work out great. So I stick to my perfect client now more than I ever have before. And so more of a business by design. So that's really my advice number one.
Yeah, building brand. I mean, early on, if you don't have anything and you didn't join like an operating team that's feeding you leads, like you've got to eat. So
yeah,
you gotta hustle.
You do. The second thing I wanted to say is I think that it's really important setting up just some simple, like number one, setting up a business where you're highly referred. If you can, referred leads are the very, very best. I know that there's all this online and you get all from all these different places. So the perception, when people call you or engage with you, you want whatever branding or image that you put yourself out there, whether it's online or your marketing materials, your branding. You want to make sure that when they call you, they have that same congruent feeling. So a way that I do that, monster fast on the follow-up. Like if we don't get back with someone within an hour, that's too much for me. So making sure that whether it's email, text, Facebook, that you've got those channels covered as far as being able to engage quickly with the prospective people that are calling you. Were you responding quickly? I use Calendly. I am here. They're not paying me to advertise for them, but it's like your own personal scheduling assistant. Get in my calendar, whether it's Calendly or something else. I'm whipping fast with the clients in the beginning to where they're like, oh my gosh, like she's, you know, my email rolls over to my assistant. Like I have coverage when I'm away for a couple of hours. My business, things are running without a beat. So making sure that you're able to quickly respond to people. And then a couple other little things. I write a handwritten thank you note to everybody that even thought about doing business with us. They get it within a week. Okay. So like a quick turn time. After we do the consultation, I do an honor call. I call it honor call, where I call, thank you so much for choosing us. I'm so honored. And they get another handwritten note. So a couple of the little things that help you stand out, because they may initially think that they're going to use you, but they can get gobbled up by another lender or realtor in a hot minute. They visit an open house, and if you don't give them those warm and fuzzies, and with me, they're like, oh my gosh, I made application with Jen, and within a few days, I get this handwritten note with a lottery ticket in it that cost me a dollar. Like, it doesn't have to cost a ton of money, that says, hey, thanks for taking a chance with us. Look forward to consulting you further. So they're having this feeling, okay, she's quick on follow-up. She was on task. She told me she was going to call me. I did Calendly. It said she was going to call me at 5:15. She called me at 5:15. Okay. Like, so if you're going to do these things, make sure that you're on task, organized, calling people when you say you're going to call them. And they're going to start to assemble their perception of professionalism about you. And I just think that the handwritten note and the call, that's something that your competition, I can tell you, is not doing. They're not.
You're molding them into a raving fan, and
I'm nurturing them from the beginning. And sometimes people aren't a fit and they want to go online and they want a discount price. And I tell them, I just don't think we're a fit for you. I think that you're better. Yes, you're better served doing online LendingTree. Yes. Mm-hmm. I mean, I have told people that. And if they come back, they come back many times, but I give them the best consultation that I can. I'm going to give that to them regardless, the best education. And I'll tell you, you haven't asked me this yet, but I'll just tell you, the number one thing in the last year, my business has really been kind of exploding. And the one thing that has changed most drastically is I've started to really beef up my YouTube. So the branding of, you know, I got a Loan with Jen logo and it's a consistent through my branding, and Connor helped me. Love Connor, by the way. Is he on later?
No, he's not on today, but he may be listening.
Hey, Connor.
Connor Steinbrook's what she's talking about.
So I saw Connor and I was like, I have to hire this dude to give me the shortcuts on how to get, you know, more presence on YouTube. So I'm not doing it to be a YouTuber. I'm doing it for branding. So all the videos that I've done, go to Loan with Jen on YouTube, Loan with Jen, please subscribe. I've got now a library of over 200 videos. I release two a week for the last year. That basically is educating people. So that's, you know, whatever your big thing is, mine is education. I'm like, look, you've been referred to me. I'm going to give you the very best education possible. And if we're a fit for each other, that's fantastic. And if not, that's okay too. We're going to wish you well. And I'm just going to know that you were referred by Chris. I've promised him I'm going to give you the very best education and save you hours of online research, because that's just what I do. I love it. And if we're a fit for you, that's great. So I've really adopted that as my script, and that's truly how I feel. And it's actually getting me more business. So whatever your elevator pitch is, whatever your branding is, you've got to really make sure everything is congruent in that. Your follow-up, your touch points, the handwritten note or the call, or just in this world of everyone's texting, I still do some of the old school stuff. I still do the handwritten note. I still do just a call to call people, even if I'm leaving them a message, or send a text video. I send a lot of text videos. So I believe that you have to do a little of all of it, because you don't know the recipient, what they're going to favor.
You're going, and we got like 30 seconds. So you're going where they are, and you're connecting with them. And then of course you're doing, like, everything works and everything doesn't work. Direct mail works, but direct mail doesn't work. Video works, but video doesn't work. It's how do you implement that in the broader strategy of building your brand. Definitely connect with her at Loan with Jen. Check out our YouTube channel. Thanks again.
Thank you. Good luck, everybody.